BBC Audio presents Patrick Hamilton, Rope, Gaslight, Hangover Square and more, a collection of 7 full-cast radio dramatisations of the thriller writer's works. Patrick Hamilton is renowned for his gritty slice-of-life tales chronicling the hopes, dreams and obsessions of London's working class in the interwar years. This collection brings together his key pieces, together with some lesser-known classics and a bonus 2004 documentary, exploring his achievements and legacy.
Hangover Square, a story of Darkest Earl's Court by Patrick Hamilton, dramatised for radio by Sam Boardman Jacobs, with Nicholas Farrell as George Harvey Bone and Amanda Redman as Netta. Hangover Square, a London hotel room, October 1938.
This morning, I had another talk with the German Chancellor, Herr Hitler. And here is the paper which bears his name upon it as well as mine. We regard the agreement signed last night and the Anglo-German naval agreement as symbolic of the desire of our two peoples never to go to war with...
Bloody farce.
Pussy! Hello. Yeah. You're not celebrating either, are you?
Betrayed! You're not an appeaser either, Puss.
But I've saved you some milk.
There. So what's the party like out there in Darkest Earl's Court? I see. Well, pity you're not interested in golf.
Nobody else is. Not now.
So, what do you think of the odds, Pussy? Will I meet a glamour girl tonight?
Me, please, love.
I say, I think I've left my money in the motor.
You haven't got a car, Peter.
I've already poured them.
I know I haven't got a motor, Enid old horse, but Gerald has.
Who's Gerald?
Mickey's cousin.
He went an hour ago.
It was Squiffy.
Or who isn't?
I've got to have that money. Or shall I call the governor?
Look, I simply left my money.
I don't care who's left what in where.
Bloody typical. Insulted Englishman in his own country.
Oh, don't start being boring, Peter. Not tonight.
I say, mind if I butt in?
Well, only if you've got a spare pound note, old chap.
13 and 9 pence halfpenny. And have one yourself, miss.
Oh, thank you very much, sir. I'll drink to peace, shall I?
You do that. I say, this is very white of you, old chap.
George Harvey Bird, how do you do?
Happy now that you've got a tune out of the old Jewish piano?
What?
The cash register, old chap. Every ring is music to their money-grubbing ears. Still, old Neville's put a stop to them dragging us into a war. A big hand for our benefactor.
Just give me my drink, Peter. My stomach thinks my throat's been cut.
Is that yours?
As long as it's wet.
You're pickle, Enid, old horse.
George Harvey Bone, how do you do?
Enid stays close. Pleased to meet you, George.
Mine's the gin and it.
Here we are, Hart. Say thank you to the nice man.
I'm Netta London. Thank you, George Harvey Bone.
The pleasure's mine.
I very much doubt it.
What a big chap you are, George. What a tiny gin, Peter.
I could get you another, Ned.
I'll have to go soon. Up at Sparrow's.
I almost forgot that the working world soldiers on.
What time do you start, Ned?
Too early. I shall have to cut out of this, too, just when the fun's starting.
A career girl. Aren't you, Hart?
If you don't mind my asking...
She's a film actress, don't you know?
A glamour girl?
Oh, no, George. A fireside girl. Definitely a fireside girl.
What time is it?
Hold on.
I say, what a big shiny gold ticker. Not a horrible Hebe, are you?
I'm sorry?
Hebrew, old chap, one of the chosen people.
Oh, I see. No, I'm not. Not the last time I looked, anyway.
It's a caution.
Time?
It's 9:30.
Beauty sleep.
Off you go.
I hope you don't mind my asking, but where?
Denham Film Studio.
Boreham Wood, just before you fall off the bloody edge, old chap.
No, Peter, it's where one mixes with the right sort if one is serious about one's profession.
Annette is very serious, aren't you, her?
Of course I am.
I could run you there, Annette.
Oh, do you have a motor car, then?
Oh, definitely.
How kind of you. I have to leave the flat at 6:30 sharp.
Some things are worth getting up early for. Where do you...
Moscow Mansions, corner of Cromwell Road and Earl's Court Road.
She'll be waiting under the Rococo cherubs, won't you, Hart?
I never wait. Still being a dark horse, George?
About what?
Your crust. How you earn it?
Don't have an actual job. It used to be something of a golf pro.
I see.
Did well in the minor league. Came into a spot of money, though, and a bit put by.
Well, this is the last.
What?
Last morning's shooting. Then it's in the can.
The film's finished.
Great, so. I only had a week's work on the thing.
Can Enid get you more jobs?
Enid?
Well, isn't she in the business?
Assistant to a producer's assistant.
What?
No, George, Enid can't.
Can I still come round and see you from time to time?
If you want to.
Lovely voice, Annette. My fireside girl.
I've never said I was yours, George. It's only a song.
No, you're a real glamour girl. You know I want to marry you.
Please, George, I've never given you any indication.
No, I know, I know. But it's been the best month of my life. And hope springs eternal.
Haven't you had enough?
Pick it up, George.
Hello?
Give it to me.
Sounds like a lounge lizard.
Shut up!
Not you. Well, I might. And then again, I just might not. Yes. All right. We'll see. Bye.
Who was it?
You're drunk and should go home. I want to be up early.
You've got a part in another film.
No, and don't rub it in.
Sorry, Nat, I just thought you might have got work.
I don't work. I'm an artiste. Or did you expect me to volunteer for digging air raid trenches in Holland Park? You'd like that, wouldn't you? Bloody warmonger.
No, I don't like war, but I do think Chamberlain should have stood up to Hitler.
War might be fun. Not that there'll be one, of course.
Fun.
Yes, fun, George. Men in uniforms, men with spunk. Excitement.
Nessa, I've made you angry. I'm so sorry.
So you should be poking your nose into my private phone calls.
I've taken the car back.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The motor. I rented it. I'm not really rich, you know.
I see.
When we met, I'd just had a win on the pools.
The pools?
200 smackers.
Oh.
Of course, I have some money.
And only one suit.
What?
You've been wearing that one for the last month, George.
I wanted to come clean.
Don't, please.
But I haven't slept because of you.
George, no.
There is no other woman for me, Ned.
You're drooling on my frock!
I'm not very drunk. It's just that I haven't slept much. Nat.
Please! I think you've had your money's worth now.
I can still stay around you, can't I?
Just go!
Nat, I know you're not a fireside girl, but I don't care.
I love you.
Goodbye, George Harvey Bone.
I'll go. Oh, goodness, I'm so sorry.
Good night, Bone.
I love you.
I didn't ask for that.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.